Hey everybody, so I'm back to do another new drugstore foundation first impression review, and today we are going to be reviewing the Maybelline Dream Velvet Soft Matte Hydrating Foundation. The fact that it says hydrating and matte is a little confusing to me because usually matte foundations are very drying. I have shade 75 Natural Beige, and I bought this online because I couldn't find it in any of my drugstores yet, so I just went to drugstore.com and purchased it for about $8. It claims to be flawless. It's supposed to have a fresh gel velvet soft texture. And it's supposed to perfect your complexion and have like a smooth, soft, matte finish and feels fresh with lasting hydration. So it doesn't say anything about oil control or how long specifically it's supposed to last. So we can't say there's any specific claims on that, but we're gonna test it out. So I'm gonna clip my hair back and excuse me for sniffling and wiping my nose a lot. It's definitely gonna be put to the test because my nose is super like raw and dry right now because I'm getting over a cold, and then of course the rest of my face is usually oily and I have blemishes right now, and it's a hot mess. So this foundation is definitely gonna be tested out. There are no real claims or instructions on how you're supposed to apply it, so I'm gonna put it through the usual test of a beauty blender that's damp and a flat top synthetic brush, which is from Amazon. Coupon code will be down below, as always, with my shade comparison. I went with my usual rule that if it says natural beige, then it most likely will work for me, though that usually works better in the warmer seasons, and it is basically winter right now, so it might be a little on the tanner side of me, but we'll find out. It has like a thicker gel feel for sure, but it wasn't hard to squeeze out. Shade is looking good. Didn't say anything about coverage either, so let's see. This is so trippy, guys. Like, it definitely is, look, I already went to the other side of my face, my bad. I'll stop. But it is giving me good coverage, and it feels really good on the skin. Like, it's just melting in almost like a moisturizer. It doesn't feel heavy, and it's giving me really good coverage. Like, it's at a good medium right now. And it still looks natural because of the finish. The finish is definitely not dewy, not fully matte. So I get the soft matte concept right now. It's really nice. It blends really well. It's covering the redness around my nose, no problem. Without looking overly dry on those spots too. That's really cool. The shade is really nice in person. I wouldn't say this is full coverage at all. It's definitely a good medium. I'm gonna put a little bit more on my hand and go in with the flat top. A little bit doesn't seem to go a long way, so that's a little concerning because there's only one fluid ounce. And if it takes a lot to cover your face, that would not be productive. The foundation itself feels cold when you apply it, so it's kind of soothing. It's a little different. Like, it feels colder than just like a typical liquid foundation would. But it goes away really, really fast. It's blending well with both applicators. But to me, it looks like you get more coverage, surprisingly, with the sponge, which is usually used to thin stuff out. This brush is just not doing it. You just try to build some coverage. I mean, it does the job. I feel like the sponge is faster, but both are good. For sure. But I feel like I used twice as much with the brush than I did the sponge. So that's just a reference on how much like a little bit goes a long way as far as what you use. It looks good in the picture. It's not too white casty. It doesn't seem to have any SPF from what I see. It feels really good on the face, guys. I'm not even kidding. It feels really good, really lightweight, and it doesn't seem like it needs a primer or anything off of just application. Like, my fine lines and pores are covered very, very well. So I'm gonna finish up my face. I don't know if this finish is good enough without powder. There's no oil control, like, there's no oil control claim, so I think I might go with a light dusting of powder. Like a light coverage one, nothing with too much coverage. I think I'll probably go with my Maybelline matte and poreless powder, and then I'll take a picture of that and then a picture at the end of my finished face so we can see where the starting point is before I come back for the end of the wear test. P.S. I sound like crap, sorry. So it has been a total of 7 hours and I still sound like crap, but The foundation, surprisingly, has worn decently well. I took a picture, flash and no flash, as always. And aside from my nose, getting a little redness back, because I've been literally wiping it with the tissue all day, and it's held pretty well. Like, it still looks pretty good. I mean, everything else didn't fade with, like, a dramatic line, if you know what I'm saying. You know when a certain spot of your foundation fades off, and this looks like you're definitely missing a chunk? Everything still looks good, especially from a distance. I think some of the coverage has worn off a little bit. As you can see, my contour is not as strong anymore. And I didn't do any touch-ups as far as my face goes. All in all, it is not too oily. My nose, aside from being wiped a lot, still has a good, like, natural coverage to it. The center of my forehead is getting a little sticky. It's getting that oily dampness right now, as you can see in the pictures. And then the area next to my nose, like right here, where I think it's been wiped off, like, it definitely has been wiped off. So it's not transfer proof for sure, but it's been wiped off because I've been wiping my nose so much, and that's probably where it got oily faster. Everything else still looks really good. I would wear this foundation as an everyday foundation because of how good it felt, how light it felt, how natural the finish was. That I really liked about it. It was really fast, the shade was really good. It's not like too overly done. Sometimes when you're wearing foundation, you definitely look like, dang, like, that's like a MAC foundation, like, it looks heavy. But this looks almost like skin, kind of, if that makes sense. It definitely has like a makeup appearance, but it's definitely on the more natural side. I really don't say that often or feel that way about a lot of foundations. Usually it just looks like flawless and good. But I think this has a good finish to it. I'm usually a huge fan of Maybelline foundations, and I think this might have replaced my favorite Dream Smooth Mousse, which came in a compact once upon a time, because that's harder to find now. I've never tried the Dream Matte Mousse because I've heard pretty bad things about it as far as it like breaking people out. But the Dream Smooth one was like my favorite. I never really used the Dream Liquid, but the Dream Velvet and the, what was it called? The liquidy version. Dream, give me a sec. I can't find it right now, but it's called the Dream Wonder, the liquid one. That one's still really great too. I like this one a little bit more because it's a little bit more hassle-free. It's not as messy, and it's just as nice of a finish and good wear time-wise. The shades are always great. As far as Maybelline goes, it's pretty consistent for me, so it fits me very well. All my comparisons will be down below as far as their foundations go as well. All in all, I like it. I mean, I don't hate it. Maybelline came out with a lot of cool stuff for spring 2016. There's a translucent powder, there is a finishing spray, and I picked those both up. I also picked up a lot of their new Vivid Matte lip colors, which I'm gonna do a video on. I only have 7 out of 10 shades. I'm trying to find the darkest shade and the 2 nude shades, and once I got those, I will wear test and swatch them all for you guys. And aside from that, I have a lot of like the new foundation reviews. I'm gonna get to the Physicians Formula Air Cushion, whatever it's called, that's coming up. The Revlon one should be up very soon after this video, their new foundation. The L'Oreal one is already up, and we're just kind of in the thick of new releases right now. So I hope you guys are enjoying all of these first impression reviews. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a later video.